Today I am going to describe functions in C programming. First of all, I describe few points about functions. In C language, we can divide a large program into the basic building blocks known as function. The function contains the set of programming statements enclosed by pair of curly braces, or it is called second bracket. A function is a group of statements that together perform a task. Every C program has at least one function, which is main function. It is also called user-defined functions, and main function is also the gateway of the program. And all the most trivial programs can define additional functions. Additional functions also called user-defined functions. A function declaration tells the compiler about a function's name, return type, and parameters. A function definition provides the actual body of the function. Now, I describe the type of the functions. There are two types of functions in C programming. One is library functions, second is user-defined functions. Library functions are developed by developers, and we find the library functions in header files. And user-defined functions are the functions which are implemented by users. So, library functions are the functions which are declared in the C header file, such as scanf function, printf function, gets function, push function, self function, float function. We know the working of each of the functions. That is, scanf function is used for taking input from the keyboard. Printf function is used for display output on the screen. Gets function is used for string input. Push function is used for show string output. Self function is the mathematical functions, and also float function is the mathematical functions. Now, user-defined functions. User-defined functions are the functions which are created by the C programmer so that he or she can use it many times. It reduces the complexity of a big program and optimizes the code. That is, functions divided into library function, user-defined function. This is a graph. Now, I describe the defining a function. The general form of a function definitions in C programming language is as follows. First of all, we describe the return type, then function name, parameter list, it is optional, and inside the curly braces, we define the body of the functions. Now, I describe each of the features one by one. First, I describe return type. Return type. A function may return a value. The return type is the data type of the value the function returns. Some functions perform the desired operations without returning a value. In this case, the return type is the keyword void. If you define the return type, then it returns such type value. If you define integers, it returns integers values. If you define float, it returns floating type values. If you define character, then it returns character value. If you do not return any value, then you define the void. Now, function name. Second point. Function name. This is the actual name of the function. The function name and the parameter list together constitute the function signature. Here, we define the function name which is meaningful and which is remember inside the program. Then I define the parameter list. Parameter. A parameter is like a placeholder. When a function is invoked, you pass a value to the parameter. This value is referred to as actual parameter or argument. The parameter list refers to the type, order, and number of the parameters of the function. Parameters are optional, that is, a function may contain no parameters. Now I describe the body of the functions where we implement the actual code function body. The function body contains a collection of statements that define what the function does. Now I describe simple examples. This is a simple function examples. Their function return type is int, function name is max. There is two integer parameters, int num1 and int num2, and this is the body of the functions. This function is used for calculating the maximum numbers between two numbers. Okay. In this function, return type is int or integers. The function name is max. Here you look is num1 and num2 are two integer parameters of the functions. Here num1 and num2 are integer parameters. And this is a function which is used to calculate maximum of two numbers. You know that the logic, that is if num1 greater than num2, then num1 is the maximum, so result is num1. Otherwise, num2 is the maximum, so result is num2. And the value is returned result. And the result is here, integer value. Now, I describe the function declarations. Function declarations means function prototype. There is a return type, function name, and parameter list, terminated by semicolon. A function declaration tells the compiler about a function name and how to call the function. The actual body of the function can be defined separately. Parameter names are not important in function declarations. Only if their type is required, so the valid declaration of a function is int max, int num1, int num2 semicolon. Here parameter list is not, parameter name is not important. We just define the type of the parameters, that is int max, int comma int semicolon. Then function declaration is required when you define a function in one source file and you call that function in another source file. In such case, you should declare the function at the top of the file calling the functions. That is, we implement the functions and we declare the functions before the main functions. This is a simple example. In this program, we defining a function, that is after the main functions. And this is the function declarations, which is called prototype of the function. In this program, first of all, define header file. Then I define function definitions of function prototype. And this function returns integer type value, function name max. There are two parameters, name is num1 and num2, both are integer values. Then I define the main functions. Here the value a and b is integer values. A equal to 100, b equal to 200, and int return types. RET equal to max a comma b. Whatever the value is returned is stored into RET. Whatever the value is returned is stored into RET variables. Then I print the result, that is maximum value is %d RET, and we terminate program by return 0. Now I define how to implement the maximum functions. Int max 1, int max 2, their function returns int integer values, integer result. If num1 greater than num2, if condition is true, then result is num1. If condition is false, then result is num2. Whatever the value of result, it is returned. And result value is returned to RET value. Okay. Then I describe the point. While creating a function, you give a definition of what the function has to do. To use a function, you will have to call that function to perform a defined task. Okay. We call the function means this is the statement. How do you call the function? That is calling a function to get the max value. Point number two, when a program calls a function, the program control is transferred to the calling functions. That is when RET equal to max a comma b, when I call this function, that is it execute this body of the function. A called function performs a defined task. and when its return statement is executed, or when its function ending closing process is reached, it returns the program control back to the main program. That is, when we end of the function defined by return statement, when return statement is executed, then it is terminating the functions and value is stored to RET value. That is control back to the main program. To call a function, you simply need to pass the required parameters. Here in this program, maximum a comma b, here a and b are two parameters that is passed, and we know that value a corresponds to num1 and value b corresponds to num2. This value is passed and stored in num1 and num2 variable. To call a function, you simply need to pass the required parameters along with the function name, and if the function name returns a value, then you can store the return value. That is, when it is to return value result, the result value is stored to RET variable and result is shown using printf statement. I hope you understand. Now I describe different aspects of function calling. First, function without arguments and without return value. Here, no return types and parameter is not defined. In this function, we just print a message, hello world. This is a simple program. In main functions, we call the message function. When you call the message functions, it executes the simple statement. Then, number two, function without arguments and with return value. With return value. Here, function returning integer values, but there is no parameter. That is, return 2 plus 4. So, sum of the two numbers add. We call the add functions and return 6. Here, function return type is integers, but there is no return type. This is second type functions. Type of the function 3. Function with arguments and without return value. Here we pass the arguments. There are two arguments. When you call the functions add 2, 4, 2 corresponds to A and 4 corresponds to B. When you call this function, 2 corresponds to A and 4 corresponds to B, but there is no return type. This is a third type functions. No return type, but there is a parameters. When you execute this function, it returns summation of two numbers. And fourth type function, function with arguments and with return value. This function have return type and also return also parameters. When you call the functions at 2, 4, it returns integer type value. That is, return type int, function name, and parameter list. It returns addition of two numbers. Okay. Now, I describe the C library functions. Library functions are inbuilt functions which is developed by developers. And we can found it inside the header file. So, we define a header file before beginning of the program. There are the different types of header files, that is stdio.h, conio.h, mat.h. Now I describe one by one point. Library functions are inbuilt functions in C that are grouped and placed at a common place called a library. Such functions are used to perform some specific operations. For example, printf functions is a library function used to print on the console. Point number three, library functions are created by designers for compiler. All C standard library functions are defined inside the different header files saved with the extension .h. That is, when you define with .h header extension, that is header file and header file contains predefined library functions. We know that. Point number five, we need to include these header files in our program to make use of the library functions defined in such header files. Point number six, for example, to use the library functions such as printf and scanf, we need to include